Now, I don't know if you guys have seen this, but some Americans have been really worried about Australian lockdowns. And one commentator is so concerned, she wants to send US troops to liberate us. Look, I was so touched by the offer that I decided to make this message in the latest and no doubt your favourite news segment of my popular series.
From Yusuf to US.
Hi, America. It's been a tough couple of COVID years here in Australia, but we've managed to get through it with the knowledge that you have our backs. And we're really looking forward to those nuclear subs in a few decades, by the way. But we didn't know just how concerned you were about us until now.
What's actually happening under the guise of this virus is federal overreach, tyranny, totalitarianism, the kind that gives birth to evil dictatorships and human atrocities.
This is Candace Owens, who, as far as I can tell, is a passionate pro-gun Trump supporter who believes white nationalism isn't that big a deal, claims the US election was rigged and announced she'll never get the COVID vaccine. But her biggest worry? Australia's lockdown laws.
Not allowed to drink or eat while standing up anywhere. Must scan a QR code to go everywhere, literally everywhere, including toilets. No dancing anywhere.
She may be thinking of Footloose there.
Dancing? There's no dancing, right?
That's right.
What?
It's illegal.
But the more Candace read about Australia's lockdowns, the more she realised there was only one possible solution.
When do we invade Australia and free an oppressed people who are suffering under a totalitarian regime?
Candace may not always know where the camera is, but she has a point.
It's time for America to liberate... It's time for America to liberate Australia. And mates, all of us are on board.
How ridiculous.
Not too sure about that, to be honest.
Maybe she should look in her own backyard before she starts worrying about ours, I think.
Okay, forget about them. The rest of us really appreciate how much real estate we occupy in the brains of your deepest thinkers.
There's some crazy going on right now where the army is trying to keep people inside.
People aren't allowed to speak to their neighbors.
So a national manhunt for a man who sneezed in an elevator. That's the state of play in modern day Australia.
America, it means a lot that you're so distressed by our plight.
Especially given that you've recorded more than 730,000 COVID deaths from more than 45 million confirmed cases. That's almost double the population of Australia, by the way.
So, America, Australia welcomes you and your blemish-free record of liberating countries that you've decided are in trouble. And we'll be ready to welcome you at all of our major cities. Auckland, Wellington, Christchurch, and even Dunedin. Just don't tell the French that we invited you. That's still kind of a sore spot. See you soon.
That was great. I'm not worried, guys, because our other ally, France, will come and they've got our back.
Oh, Naz, we've got to tell you something, mate. There's been some developments.
I didn't hear a lot of what she said. I was so mesmerised by her sleeves and the fact that she was on the set of American Idol. What was she doing there?
Well, if you find the keys and you sneak on late at night, you can make a whole show for yourself.
It is nice that America cares about us.
Oh, look, I think it probably comes from a place of concern, genuinely. I think if you take anything out of context, but yeah, it's wild stuff. Yeah. It really is.
Full on.
Ironic wanting to invade us on Freedom Day as well.
Yeah. Anyway.